Mariah had a hidden belief that what she wants, she can't necessarily have. She was really struggling between trying to think positively and thinking fearful thoughts. I told her to ask God for ease. Ask this all-powerful, all-knowing energy to help you give up struggle and resistance. There's a huge advantage to giving up the struggle. There's no reason for it. And it's self-imposed every time. Not to mention, it causes you to work against you. Once you get that, things will get easier. Your soul knows where it stands in relation to everything you want. It knows what all your beliefs are that are in the way of manifesting your soulmate. Your soul also knows the path of least resistance. And you can feel comfort in knowing that your soul is not saying, clean up your act, become the happiest person you know, and then I'll help you. Your soul says, you are where you are. What you want is what you want. And with all of this in mind, when you are in alignment with soul, you are tapped into the path of least resistance. See, your soul makes things as easy as you let it be. But your soul cannot believe for you. It can only know what it knows, which is that God wants to give you what you want, like a parent to a child. So Mariah responded with, I've been dating for a few years and I've put so much energy, time, and money into finding my soulmate, but the universe won't budge. She went on saying, I get really excited about hiring matchmakers. I find moments of optimism in going to singles events and swiping through dating apps, but still nothing. What if there's a different destiny for me? One where I'm just not meant to be married. Mariah was complaining about the fact that she is optimistic about dating and doing all the manifestation mindset work, but still not seeing results. She shared that she's learning and growing through this process as well. But the truth is, while she is optimistic and excited about parts of the process, she's also skeptical in her belief. She also shared that the universe won't budge, which is also a belief. See, here's the thing. She loves parts about dating, but she doesn't love other parts. She tells us a lot about her true belief in this. Mariah's belief is that the universe won't budge. And she's not making this belief up. It comes from somewhere. She's seeing it happen in her real life. She dates, but she doesn't meet her soulmate. So it creates a hidden belief of skepticism. And then she builds up excitement for the next round, only to continue holding on to this belief of skepticism. It's a lot to ask somebody to not believe what is. So I'm not saying don't believe it. I'm not telling you to lie to yourself, because the proof behind her belief is that Mariah is still single. So the practice is not in not believing. I heard this next line given over in a talk once, and I fell in love with this practice. The practice is to not give your attention to beliefs that hurt you when you give your attention to beliefs that hurt you. Again, do not give your attention to beliefs that hurt you when you find yourself giving attention to beliefs that hurt you. I'm going to say this one more time because it's really important. Do not give your attention to beliefs that hurt you when you find yourself giving attention to beliefs that hurt you. There is absolutely nothing good that comes out of giving your attention to a belief that hurts you. Every time you do this, you enter into the vibration of it and you block it from manifesting. You end up making things hard for yourself. The universe won't budge because your beliefs don't budge. And your beliefs don't budge because you become hyper-focused on what is. Still being single holds you in the energy that comes with still being single, which stops you from creating a new reality. So ultimately, I'm not saying not to believe it, but rather to replace the beliefs that hurt you with other beliefs that don't hurt you. For example, saying things like, I'm really good at dating and I'm really good at meeting new people. And look how many awesome people I get to interact with during this dating process. And wow, thank God there are single men out there. All it takes is one to be my soulmate, and I believe that that one is coming my way. Open your valve and let the energy that creates the world flow through you. This is the path of least resistance. Life is always going to present a new desire that you're not up to speed with at the beginning. So when you have thoughts like, maybe I'm just meant to let the desire go and be single for the rest of my life, the answer is no way. That's never the answer, especially when what you want is to be married. Be persistent in the pursuit of your dreams. Source energy responds to that. The answer is to replace the belief that hurts you with a belief that doesn't hurt you. The answer is to let the creative energy of God flow through you. The answer is to tap into the knowledge of your soul that is constantly trying to guide you in the right direction. The answer is to choose faith over fear. Just believe. Sharing is caring, so if you liked what you heard, pay it forward. Share this with a friend. And as always, happy manifesting.